I thought actually John Bon Jovial, I thought he explained their muse and where they get their influence from very very perfectly clear earlier in the conversation when he said more beer. Yeah. I thought that sort of summed it up right there.
More beer.
But hey, listen, Phil, tell us now, this is from a forthcoming album, and before we run out of time, we wanna give you a chance to talk about a little bit about the new album.
Of course, yeah. Well, there is a clip that's going around at the minute, and we're very, really happy, actually, how well it's done. It's on our Facebook page, and I think that's where you originally saw us, wasn't it, Dave? Where you contacted us is through Facebook.
Yes, right. I was able to find you there, and I want to be sure that you tell the folks how they can find you, because, as
yeah,
I mentioned,
of course. Well,
there's a lot of references to the movie and stuff in there.
Yeah, there is. That's the thing. I mean, obviously, hopefully, if we do get bigger as a band, it will be easier to find. There's like a million and one bands out there now, isn't there, with names named after different things. But for us, yeah, if you want to find us, you best just go in on www.facebook.com, obviously / Breaking Waves Official, and you'll be able to find our latest video on there, and it gives you a demo of the album. There's about 7 tracks we've got chopped together. It's 7 tracks from the album, one of them being the track that you played, Big Trouble, and a few other bits and bats on there, and it just gives the listener and the viewer a bit of a feel of what we're all about, I think, that video. It seems to be doing okay for us so far. We've had a lot of shares anyway, so, you know, we're really happy with it, and fingers crossed it can, you know, it'll get shared a bit more, and there'll be a bit more interest in us in the future. That's all you can ask for.
Well, I think with what you're doing, that's a given. You're definitely going to pick up. You're going to pick up listeners as your song is played, and they get to hear it. And we're going to let them hear another track right now, as we thank you so much for joining us, sharing the music, and remind you, as we do all of our guests, you're now a member of the family. John Bon Jovi will take over a second. I think I'm going to cough here.
Yeah. Well, basically what David's trying to say here, because he kind of lost his voice for a second, is that look, once you're on with us, you're a member of the family. We want you to keep us posted. We want you, anything new that comes along, let us know so we can post it for you. You can go to Facebook, and David's got a couple of pages on there for the David Bowers Awards, for the David Bowers, and these are pages that basically are dedicated solely to what you and Pete and all the other people that we have come on the show. It's for you guys to let the world know what we're doing. So, David, is your voice back?
Thank you very much. Yes, I am back. My voice is back. And thank you for jumping in there like that. As I was saying, though, Phil, thank you so much for joining us. You are indeed
a
member of the David Bowers Awards family now. Use those pages on Facebook. That's what they're there for my guests to come on and post your play dates, your new releases, your promo, whatever you've got to do with your music. There's one more place you can add to your PR list to put your press releases on and tell us what's going on. Keep in touch with the people over.
Thank you. Well, we certainly will. We certainly
will. All right.
Will. And if we ever play the States, we'll have to put some tour dates on there.
Absolutely.
You
keep in touch. You keep in touch with us, because we want to know what's going on and how you're doing. So we look forward to hearing from you.
Thank you very much anyway. Cheers for that. Thank you.
Great. Thank you. That's Phil Ireland of the band Breaking Waves, and this is called Black Eyes, Blue Skies.
In the morning, what's up with my eyes? I still get up in the morning. I'm going out in the evening, dressing in a disguise. I'm going out in the evening, trying to make a new high. Don't wanna justify. We're up in anymore.
This is Frank Herbert, and you're listening to the David Bowers Awards on Blog Talk Radio. Enjoy the evening.
And there you have it, Breaking Waves from merry old England. And we've got to move right along right now because we have another guest coming on who's an old friend of ours and has been on several times in the past. And I have to say, thanks to the Bellamy Brothers, and especially to Wally, who engineers these kind of things. I'm going to get to see the boys here in the very near future, and I'm definitely looking forward to that. So we're going to be talking to Howard of the Bellamy Brothers right after we listen to the record that made them international heroes. Here you go, ladies and gentlemen. Let your love flow.
There's a reason for the sunshine sky, and there's a reason why I'm feeling so high. Must be the season when that love light shines all around us. So let that feeling grab you deep inside and send you reeling where your love can't hide, and then go stealing through the moonlit nights with your lover. Just let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow with the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love bind you to all living things, and let your love shine, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason. There's a reason for the warm, sweet nights, and there's a reason for the candlelights. Must be the season when those love rays shine all around us. So let that wonder take you into space and lay you under its loving embrace. Just feel the thunder as it warms your face. You can't hold back. Just let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow with the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love bind you to all living things, and let your love shine, and you'll know what I mean. That's the reason. Just let your love flow like a mountain stream, and let your love grow with the smallest of dreams, and let your love show, and you'll know what I mean. It's the season. Oh, let your love fly like a bird on a wing, and let your love bind you to all living things, and let your love shine, and you know what I mean. That's the reason. Just let your love flow.
And there you have it. Let your love flow, the Bellamy Brothers, and we're fortunate to have one of the brothers with us right now. Howard, come on in and say hello.
Dave, how are you doing, man?
Doing just fine, and so glad you could be with us here today. How are you guys doing?
We're doing well. I don't know why. We're doing better than we deserve, really.
Well, it appears that you're doing very well, and from what I hear, you earned the most of it. We're sorry to hear you've lost your bassman and harmonicat there for a little while with some surgery he's got to have. Wally is sidelined for.
Yeah, well, thank you. Yeah, Wally's been with us 36 years. He's having a few problems now, but hopefully he'll overcome it.
Absolutely. We wish him the very best. Met him a couple of times, and he's just a great guy, and I know what an addition to the show he is. Speaking of things from the past and strange things that have come along, and we just played Let Your Love Flow, we were just recently made aware of the strange backstory on that. Something about the song Let Your Love Flow was written by a roadie for Neil Diamond.
That's right. Yes, Larry Williams. Really, the only I guess maybe it's not the only song he ever wrote, but it's the only hit song he ever wrote. And we had just moved out to Los Angeles, David and me, and because David wrote "Spiders and Snakes" for Jim Stafford, and so in the group we were involved with, moved out and we're working on a. What was the old Smothers Brothers TV show? Jim was going to take that over, and we were writing for the show. I was working with Jim, and we befriended Neil Diamond's band, a good group to hang out with. And we had a lot of the same habits in those days, so you can figure that out.
Yeah, absolutely.
Dennis St. John was Neil's drummer, and he came over to our house one night, and he brought this demo of Let Your Love Flow, and he said, "Hey guys, this sounds like something you could really do." And when I heard it, I thought it was the best song I'd ever heard in my life. We had a hard time getting the label to record it. They resisted.
Really?
Record labels never have.
You personally had a little bit of a hard time with it too, right?
Yes, I did. Well, the day we finally got the track cut and everything, I had just come in off of the road. I'd been working with Jim and out on the road, and I had to do the vocal, and I had a high fever and a bad flu. It was just awful, and pain.
God.
You know, flu is like